acceptable.
Mr. President, Majesty.
Good morning, President. Good to see you. Good to see you, sir. It's been a long time.
It sure has. Many minutes to come in.
Thank you, sir.
I think we have to put up with
yes, sir, the usual.
Three waves of the press.
Thank you, sir.
Chit-chat and small talk until the
it's a beautiful day.
Today?
I think I followed the president's example and better about that.
Are you making any progress with Iraq and Syria?
That's another question.
Lights, please. Thank you. This way, please. Thank you. This way, please. Yeah. This way. Thank you. Riding pole this way, please. Thank you. You could come out this way.
Mr. President, what assistance you can give King Hussein to help him in the peace process?
This is what we'll be discussing.
Lights, please. Thank you. This way, please.
This way. Come on, my darling. Come with me.
This way, please.
Thank you.
Studying it in detail, moving quickly on its recommendations. And I want to assure you that your contribution will have a most profound impact on the future of the American space program. One of the great things about our country is that we can look at our mistakes in the public arena, correct them, and move on ahead. And I'll say that publicly in just a few minutes inside. And again, let me just say to all of you on behalf of your country, thank you very much for a job well done. And so now I want to hear more about your report.
Mr. President, I think the remarkable thing about our report is we finished. And I've been trying to think about why we were able to complete it in 120 days. And I thought of good reasons such as we're very conscientious, hardworking, and all those things. But actually, I guess the secret is that none of us were getting paid. So we had no incentive to stay on the payroll. I just want to say, Mr. Burton, that this has been the finest group I've been associated with in terms of dedication, hard work. As you said, many of the members of the commission gave up their jobs completely. considerable sacrifice. I worked long hours, and the report is a report generally from the commission. It's not a staff report. It's not written by any person. For about 12 days, we sat in the room and went over this report page by page, and these distinguished ladies, distinguished gentlemen made their comments, and I think that it's responsive to your request, and I think it'll be constructive as far as the nation is concerned. We appreciate the opportunity to serve you, to serve the country.
Well.
Good afternoon. Please call me somewhere else.
Prevent such a tragedy from occurring again. And I look forward to reading and reviewing it in thorough detail. And let me give my heartfelt thanks to the members and staff of the Rogers Commission. They've performed their task with distinction, and it was an arduous one. To a nation still suffering from the trauma of the loss of a child.
Safer and better prepared for the challenges that lie ahead. I want to thank the Congress for letting the commission proceed on the National Transportation Safety Board and others whose cooperation made the commission's report possible. And today we see once again, and although the lessons of failure are hard, they are often the most important on the road to progress. We've learned in these past few months that our errors, because we don't hide our mistakes, we're not condemned to repeat them. American people, because we trust, base our trust on the American people. And that's why we can look to their wisdom, creativity, to show us the way. It's been a difficult passage for America, but we will go on just as the crew of the Space Shuttle Challenger would have wanted us to. We'll use every ounce of America.
Wiser this time and undaunted as the spirit of the Challenger and her seven heroes. I thank all of you so much. God bless you all. Now, Bill Rogers.
On behalf of the commission, I want to say that it's been an honor and a privilege to have served you, and in so doing, served the nation. When we accepted this responsibility, we knew the importance of the task. However, we did not anticipate the difficulty, but certainly agreed to by all of us, has been responsive to your request. We hope, Mr. President, that our work will serve the best interests of the nation in restoring the space program of the United States.
Intact here except for one, General Chuck Yeager, who couldn't be with us here today, but we thank him as well as all of these wonderful people who've done so much. we spend all this money and build another team.
He's on this.
We go away. We want to know where we're going. We've got a very simple plan. We can shut it off anytime we want. You know, there's no big cap. That's why we're starting broadcasting in Portuguese and Spanish on July 1st to Latin America.
They in Spanish, he said, you know, over at Johnny's house, they got a box there. And you can hear all this stuff, and you don't have to look at anything but you
Marti. He was a Castro supporter when Castro promised the deliverance of the Cuban people, and then he realized at great personal risk that he was the wrong guy, and he's trying to bail Marti. I gave Tom a copy of George Wolfe's column on the saw last Sunday, extolling Radio Marti's effectiveness. And you were one of the influential people who voted for it. Jay Mallon.
I didn't ask the question, but I mean, he is.
And
I'm
young man.
I heard that. I see all the time on the White House once in a while.
Well, thank you. Nice to see you. Well, all right. This could be kind of an easy one to do.
So you think Spanish is pretty good, obviously?
No.
I see.
I remember even a horrible tale. I remember those days back there. Mr. Castro Holden, the scene of recording the George Washington of Cuba. Didn't turn out that way. Sure.
My lunch.
Well, oh, where am I?
Right here.
Oh, I'm right here. I'm right.
You want to study the dream, Mr. Cornfield?
I have no comments. We're talking to the other speaker. Nice to meet you. I started my career in radio.
Well, Mr. President, it's really a pleasure, and we are very grateful that you have given us some time to give an interview to Radio Marti. As you know, we have been on the air now for a year, and we certainly welcome the opportunity of getting your comments to the Cuban people through Radio Marti.
Well, I'm very pleased to have the opportunity.
Well, let's start with some of the questions we had prepared. Mr. President, the Cuban government says that the United States is conducting imperialist aggression against the legitimate government of Nicaragua. What is your reaction to this charge?
Well, if I were not as used to the extravagant claims of Cuban propaganda as I am, I would be outraged by such a charge. First of all, there are no U.S. forces in Nicaragua.
Next question.
How are you?
Good, sir. How are you today?
Pretty good.
Nice to see you. Thank you for seeing us. This is Kristen. So say hi, Mr. President. And this is Erica, who we also call Rambo.
Hi, Erica. Rambo.
And Alyssa. And my wife, Karen.
Hello, Elizabeth.
Hi.
We did something about the gender gap problem.
Yes.
How should we do this? Can I pick up the little guys here and hold them? And
if you pick up one, I'll pick up another.
Okay.
She'll let me.
I think she will. She's
kind of
pretty good girl.
So,
Well, and let's get together in a group picture here.
Oh, well, you're nice. I tell you, we've had 5.5 wonderful years with you, Mr. President.
We're missing a photographer.
I just called it.
Okay. See, we don't have a photographer yet.
No, we got the TV, but we don't have a stuff photographer.
Well, I hadn't even looked up the
other.
Well, you may want to put that on.
She's a showing picture.
Yeah, she's
Is he coming?
He doesn't have
the room. If I can ever help, as all your deporting staff say, I'm glad to do it.
Thank you.
Particularly to lead the charge to repeal the 22nd Amendment.
Well, I think that frankly, not for me, no, it should be done for whoever comes after, but it should be repealed.
Well, you make the best case.
I just think that, the whole thing is, I think it's an interference with the democratic rights of the people.
I'm going to go over there.
Able to go over there.
Here, we'll try this again.
Can you try this again with me?
Say yes.
Yes.
Would you mind me?
Well,
okay, you don't have to hold on to it, yes?
No,
we've
got to come here.
Over here. There,
see
over here?
Okay.
That camera.
That's good. Thank you, sir.
Thanks.
Okay.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Really, so thank you.
We all appreciate it.
It's been a real honor to be part of your staff.
Well, just some souvenirs.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Yes. You're stuck halfway through a book. It's a book, man.
Great. Okay, thank you.
And in here.
Oh. Those little eyes. Those little eyes.
Yes. There's a jar of jelly beans.
Uh-oh. They won't last very long.
And these are just. Knowing that's all wrapped up for now, those are samples of what's in the jar.
Maybe we can give them one of those.
So that maybe on the way home, they
definitely.
Yeah, your mother, your mother approves.
Okay.
Well, thank you again.
That's terrific.
All right.
Can you girls say goodbye?
Say goodbye. Can you say goodbye?
Bye. Goodbye.
Thank you again, sir.
You bet.
We appreciate it.
Bye. Bye.
Yeah.
Here we go. We'll do this way.
Okay. Come on here.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Documentary film to be shown in the United States on how wonderful the Sandinistas are. They're the good guys and so forth. One of them is a former husband of Betty Davis, Gary Merrill. And give you an idea of how sound and solid he is in his thinking, this gentleman brought the report back so that Gary told him he liked it down there because he could wear a skirt and nobody made anything out of it. Seems that important name recently, Gary's been wearing a skirt. Why didn't he shorten it and call it kilts?